Good afternoon, children. Welcome back to Social Science class. In previous class, we all discussed the introduction of Dutch and the trading centers of Dutch. Today, we are going to discuss what did the Dutch decline in India. Today, we will discuss decline of Dutch in India. India. What are the reasons or what are the causes to decline Dutch in India? See here, first cause to decline Dutch in India. Dutch English. See children, first cause for decline of Dutch in India. First cause what? Dutch. Clash is what? With the English. In this, Dutch were defeated. Defeated by English. Understand children? First cause means what? Dutch clashed or fought with the English. In this, Dutch were defeated by English. This is the first cause for decline of Dutch in India. Second one is Dutch were competition. Understand children? Second cause of decline of Dutch in India. Dutch were not able to face the English competition in India. And Dutch were islands of South Asia. Understand children? These are the three causes for decline of Dutch in India. First one is Dutch clashed or fought with the English. In this, Dutch defeated by English. Second one, Dutch were not able to face the English competition in India. And third one, Dutch were turned their attention towards islands of Indonesia. These are all causes of decline Dutch in India. Understand children? Next, Dutch chapter who came to the India. It means the Dutch chapter English were came to India. Now we will discuss Europeans of English. Europeans of English. Dutch author who came to India? Dutch author English one came to India. They were came to India in the year 1600 to 1947 Common Era. Understand children? English were came to India in the year 1600 Common Era. Understand? When they were came to India in the beginning. In the beginning. They were They political supremacy. Understand children? Very important. In the beginning, they means British or British to follow peaceful trade policy in India. After that, they took the advantages of political situation in India. After that, English were established their political supremacy in India. Understand children? See here. Merchants eastern. Countries of eastern. Asparagus, Andesian. Our mother tongue China is going to eastern. Country is going to be our Abhivruddhi Maadikonnavaru ambition anna bandiddare yavo English anna. In the English, what trees have to aspirate in countries of eastern countries? And also, they were established East India Company. English, East India Company. In the year 1600 common era. 1600 common era. They were established the East India Company. They were established East India Company in India. English East India Company. They were established in the year 1600 common era. They were established the English East India Company. Understand? Very important this date here. English East India Company was established in the year of 1600. We can call the English East India Company in India. And also they established their trade in India with the permission of Queen of Elizabeth. Understand? After this 1600, they were stopped their trade with India in the permission of Queen of Elizabeth. Queen of Elizabeth, who took the permission, the English merchants were took the permission, the Queen of England, Queen of Elizabeth, when in the year 1600 common era, after they were start the trade with India. After this, in the beginning, East India Company ships were landed in the Surat ports. In the beginning, the English merchants ships were landed in the port of Surat. First, in the beginning, English merchants ships are landed in port of Surat. Understand? First, English merchants were ships were all landed in port of Surat. After Sir Thomas wrote, very important. Sir Thomas Roy. Sir Thomas Roy, he was the viceroy of English. He was the viceroy of English. Sir Thomas Roe visited the port of Mughal Empire, Jhansi. He visited the port of Mughal Emperor Jhansi. J. Jahangir Senior. Mughal Emperor Jahangir. Sir Thomas Roy visited the court of Mughal Emperor. His name is Jahangir in the year 1615 Common Era. In the year 1615 Common Era. 615 Common Era. Sir Thomas Roy was visited the court of Mughal Emperor. Emperor Jahangir in the year of 1615 Common Era. That time I obtained the permission to trade in Surat and took after visit they took the permission from the Jahangir to start the trade in Surat. To start the trade in Surat. Understand? Who gave the permission? The Mughal Emperor Jahangir was given the permission to start the trade in Surat in the year 1615 Common Era. After this, later trade centers were established. After this, the English were started the or established the trade centers in India. Which are the trade centers of English? Centers of English. Very important. Name the trade centers of English. First one is they were established trade centers in Agra. In Agra. Second one trade centers of English were that is Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad. Next one is Bruch. 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 And also after they established centers in Calcutta and Madras. Madras and Bombay, present Mumbai. Understand? English were established the trade centers first Agra, second Ahmedabad and Bruch and Calcutta and Madras and Bombay. And very important Calcutta. Calcutta is the capital of English. Understand? Calcutta is the capital of English. See children, which are the trade centers of English? Agra, Ahmedabad, Bruch, Abruch, Calcutta, Madras and Mumbai. It means Bombay. Understand? Calcutta is the capital of English. Understand children? These are the trading centers of British or English in India. Next. They were developed their trade in India. Gradually, the profit of East India Company is day by day was increased. The profit of the English East India India companies' profit was increased in India. They obtained the permission to the trade without any tax in the Bengal province. Understand? After this, they were obtained the permission. They gained the permission to trade without any tax in the province of Bengal. Understand? This is very, very important. Province of Bengal. Province of Bengal. Very, very important. After 1650, the East India Company was increased the profit day by day. After this, they were descended to the obtained or achieved or by the permission without paying any, without any tax in the province of Bengal. It is and also the present Bengal is Bihar and Odisha. And the present Bengal is present Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. And also in Agra from the Mughal Emperor Farrukhsia.
Dastak.
Now we will discuss meaning of Dastak. meaning of Dastar. What is the mean by Dastar? See children, Dastar means the license issued to the British traders to conduct tax-free trade in India. The license British traders to conduct tax free trade in India. Understand? Meaning of Dastar. What is the meaning of Dastar? Means the license. The license issued to the British traders to conduct tax-free trade in India. It is called what? Dastar. Understand, children? This is called what? Dastar. In order to improve their strength, to British build the ports and around their residential area and trade centers. After this, they were built the ports in the trade centers and residential area. Understand, children? After this, when they were to the trade and when they were gaining the strength in India, after they were built the force in the trade centers and residential area, and they employed the soldiers to protect their establishment and also the stocked arms and ammunition. After this work, they were appointed the soldiers to protect the trade centers and residential area. Understand, children? When they were established the fort to trading centers and residential area, after they were appointed the soldiers to protect the trade centers and also their residential area and also the stocked arms. Ammunition. nations. Understand? They were appointed to the soldiers to protect the trade centers and also residential areas and also stocked arms and also ammunition. They were appointed the soldiers to protect these. And also in a very short time, the English had a strong army. Ready? Thanks.